Adam Booth here, Upshift Online. Last time you saw this 701, it looked a lot different than this. We told you we were gonna take it away and transform the look of it. Well, here you have it, kind of a rally ADV style bike. No, it's not Andrew Short's bike. This is the 701 Husky you saw in our last video that we had a lot of other parts on. Thanks to Carl Cycles in Boise, Idaho, they transformed this in less than 24 hours from the other bike you saw in the video. We've got this cool Kriga graphics kit all over this thing, making it look pretty fancy. And we also have these Kriga bags on the back. We had a tool bag up here earlier and another bag here. We were kind of moving bags around as we went riding today and transfer weight around a little bit. So the heart of this bike is still the same. It's still a stock 701 engine, but now it features a Rottweiler intake. It's got a cool foam air filter that kind of clips onto the Rottweiler plate that leads into the intake. Along with that, there's a Rottweiler power commander, and that controls the power curve. And they've kind of remapped it so it's not so on and off. It's way more linear off idle. So when you're kind of at those fine throttles coming off idle, want to roll it on, it's way more smooth and it builds into the power smoother. So in combination with that Rottweiler intake, the Rottweiler power commander, and the Rottweiler fuel dongle on here, the slip-on Yoshimura exhaust really opens this bike up. But thankfully, with that extra power and that more gritty girth is ripping through the mid and up to the top end, that power commander is what makes it all more rideable, making it roll on smoother off idle. So there's none of this on-off, herky-jerky, too much power instantly. It's connected to the throttle, so as you turn that throttle, it's just really linear, makes power sliding fun, and it makes kind of negotiating some tight single track way easier because you're not just fighting the power and having to cover the clutch as much. It just rolls on. So the conflict suspension stayed the same from that last bike we stripped down and built this with, which was really nice because we were a little more high speed today, more fire roads, and even with some of the added weight and the features you see on this bike, it still held up really well. We were able to kind of slap through some G-out water bars, and while we felt the stops a little, it didn't roll our ankles or clank or make us scared. And also on the faster stuff with the rolling whoops and stuff, the bike stays up really well. So with the conflict suspension in combination with the Dunlop 908 Rally Raid tires front and back, it's a really good combination out on the trails. It's a good hookup. It worked well on the asphalt, in the sand. This bike is pretty heavy in the sand. It's still a beast in the sand, but if you stay on the throttle with the stiffer suspension, the front end doesn't dive nearly as much as a stock bike. So the Dunlop 908 Rally Raid tires are mounted up to a set of W wheels with Talon hubs and Excel rims. And this combination is really durable. And in the past, we've had W wheels last a very long time. We end up keeping them and putting them on every bike we have. So it's kind of like one of those purchases you keep and you just keep from bike to bike. So obviously when you look at this bike, it has that rally look to it. Well, that's thanks to this Nomad tower and windscreen and this whole thing off the front that adds actually a really cool look to these bikes. It converts that 701 into kind of like a weird dual sport, bigger dual sport, into a full-on Andrew Short, ready to hit Dakar kind of look. And this Nomad tower is pretty cool because it bolts straight onto the bike. There's no modifying, and all the wiring that goes into the Cyclops headlights here, it's all plug and play. You're not going to be stripping wires, extending wires, or doing anything. This is definitely something you can do in your own garage. It even has a place for the stock computer, has a place for the dongle on the dash, and all your lights and your turn signals and your oil light, all that's on there. This windscreen offers up a lot of protection on the freeway. It's kind of out there and puts the wind up over your head. Really cool feature about this is it's open down looking at your front wheel. So when you're standing up and riding the trail, you can look down and see on both sides of that wheel. You're not just blocked off, only seeing a tip of your front fender. So if you have a bike and you wanna actually ride it off road, you're probably gonna tip over, you might slide out, whatever. These things fall over if you're really riding them off road. So this has Outback MotorTech guards everywhere. You can see it's holding the bags in the back. It's super stable. You can pull on it, you can push on it. Your friends can get you out of the sand. These crash guards up here are kind of a must have. Because if you fall over, you're going to destroy something on the bike without these. And who cares if they're scratched up, it'll just make you look more hardcore. Also, the skid plate on this thing, it's got a lot of ground clearance. So unless you're really hammering through the rocks, but you don't ever want to smash the underside of this bike. It'd be really expensive to fix. Plus, this thing looks really cool. So we didn't swap everything out from our last project that looked completely different 24 hours ago. We kept the Fast Company flex bars because they, of course, add comfort. We have the Cycra wraparound hand guards to protect our hands. And we never ride bikes without the double take mirrors. If you don't have one, you're wasting your time with any other mirror. And I can't forget one of the other things we did not change from the other bike, because it works well no matter what you're doing with your bike, is the Seat Concept seat. This featured right here, nice and wide in the back when you're comfort, gives you enough narrowness up front to get in there and hammer the corners as much as you're gonna hammer a corner on one of these. If you're gonna be on your bike for a multi-day trip, you gotta have a Seat Concept seat. So we have a Recluse manual clutch in here. It's not the auto version. Probably later on we'll switch and try one of those as well. But it works really well in here. It's just a little more grabby, and we have confidence that it's never gonna slip on us, and we can really abuse it, especially in the tighter conditions if you're slipping the clutch and fighting through some technical terrain. So overall, it was quite a feat for Carl Cycles to take what we had before and present us with this 24 hours later the next morning. Actually, less than 24 hours. We gave it to them in the evening. They gave it to us the next day. So we spent all day riding this thing. We're super happy. Even with this, you would think this added on weight on the front would make the bike handle differently. But thanks to the stiffer suspension, it's still balanced. It's still, you don't even really notice that thing's there. After a half hour, you're not even looking. You're looking next to the cluster, around it. It's just really cool. And the bags, they stay on the racks well. I mean, this thing's just been fun. The extra power, I'm not gonna lie, and that grunty, throaty exhaust is pretty fun. It's kind of a race sounding setup. If you keep it low in the RPMs, it's not too loud, but if you wanna, you know, bark it up and really feel like a race truck, this exhaust will do it for you. We talked about the last bike, there was a little gap between first and second, and sometimes you'd have to like lug second or rev out first. Well, now second gear pulls a lot harder and smoother, where you can ride second gear where we were having to shift before. So there it is. This is the second phase of our 701 Husqvarna project. Thanks to all the companies that made it possible. Of course, Carl Cycles for putting in all the labor and helping us out. And we just want to thank everybody who supports Upshift online and makes this kind of project possible so that you can check it out and you can enjoy it. And hopefully you can take some of the elements we used, put them towards your own bike, or maybe this will inspire you to convert one of your bikes into more of a adventure rally and get out with some bags and some windscreen and just go out for a few days. If you don't do that, at least go out and ride and have some fun. So if you like these videos and what Upshift Online is doing, make sure you subscribe, make sure you check back, make sure you check our social, read the magazine, just have fun and ride bikes.